Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpandi. I have 30 plus years of experience in teaching. Recently, I have completed the IGIEP, International Engineering Educator Certification. I want to share my experience on getting the certification and the journey and my experience may help the faculty members of engineering colleges in India to think about improving or redesigning their teaching methodology. So the journey of IGIEP. IGIEP is the International Society for Engineering Pedagogy. They awarded me the certificate, International Engineering Educator. So the journey, it involves different stages. First, we have to start with the IAECP, International Engineering Education Certification Program. So the program is conducted by IUCEE, Indo-Universal Collaboration for Engineering Education. This IUCEE was promoted by Dr. Krishna Vedula, and the executive director for the program, IAEECP, International Engineering Educator Certification Program, the executive director for the program is Dr. Veena Kumar. Both of them are Indians, settled in US. And the website, www.iucee.org, you visit the website and you become the member. So the IUCEE is regularly, every week they are conducting the webinar on the topic, engineering topic, which will be useful to the teachers as well as students, those who want to aspire or do better in your profession. So you please be a member, become a member of IUCEE.org, and if you become a member, if you register yourself as a member, so they will send the mail about the program, weekly program, and you can register. If you are interested, you can register and visit, listen to the webinar. So all the webinar of the speakers of various parts of the world, starting from America to Australia. So the program, certification program, it involves three phases, phase one, phase two, phase three. Phase one, 3 days program, it is a contact program. And this certification is popular in Andhra, Karnataka and Maharashtra. So I went to SR Engineering College, Warangal in Andhra Pradesh, and attended the program, 3 days program, contact program. And on completion of 3 days program, you have to go to the phase two, which is 12 weeks online program. And phase three will be a capstone presentation. After completion, successful completion of the 12 weeks online program, then you can register for capstone presentation. So the 12 weeks online program, so it is conducted on through a LMS, Canvas instructor. It is a LMS used for the course. There are 6 modules: module 1, teaching and learning; module 2, dynamics of classroom; module 3, teaching with technology; module 4, collaborative learning; and module 5, effective assessment; and module 6, course design. For each module, the time is 2 weeks, and every Friday there will be a webinar by the expert on the topic for a duration of 1 hour 30 minutes, followed by a discussion assignment. Every week there will be one discussion, one assignment, and for a particular module there will be 2 discussions and 2 assignments. So for the discussions, the topic, the question will be posted in the discussion forum of the LMS by the course coordinator. And the course coordinator, the Dr. Veena Kumar will be throughout the program, for all the program, all the week, all the module. Every week, every session, she will be participating and motivating the learners. And for every topic, every module, there will be a expert, all of them of very good academic profile and learned process, and they are practicing the higher end teaching in institutes of international repute. And there will be two graded assignments based on the grades on the discussion and the assignment. You will be given permission for the capstone presentation. And in the discussion forum, for the, there will be a question for the discussion forum. So the question, we have to post your opinion about the question and comment on the question, and also you have to comment and opinion about the participants. So you have to comment on others' opinion, and you have to give your opinion for the question on the particular discussion week. So the assignments, I give some details about the assignment. Module 1, teaching learning. Assignment 1, my teaching philosophy is the topic. So in the topic, you have to write about my vision, my contribution towards the vision, success in my effort and future plan, area in which I need to improve my skills as an educator, methods to improve my skills as an educator, short-term goal for this year, 1 year, long-term goal for next 3 years. So this is the content of the my teaching philosophy assignment, and you have to submit on time. And assignment 2, there is one model, lecture design model, ARCS, attention, relevance, confidence and satisfaction. Using the ARCS model, you have to design a lecture. So lecture design is involved. So lecture design, you have to design the lecture, and you have to submit the assignment, and it will be evaluated by an expert. Then module 2, dynamics of classroom. So again, here active learning is discussed. So the active learning methodology is discussed in the dynamics of classroom. How to keep the classroom dynamically, engaging the students in the classroom. So the assignment 1, dynamic classroom assignment 1. So you have to design a course. You have to completely design a course. So what I have designed, the course is engineering thermodynamics. I have taken the topic for which the activity is designed, ideal Rankine cycle. So what do you have to do in the design? Strategy that I will use. What is the strategy you are going to use to keep the class dynamics? Implementation strategy, starting with an activity, and there will be a presentation, problem solving, learning styles addressed, pre-implementation reflection. So before you implement the activity, before you implement the topic in the classroom, so what do you expect? That is what pre-implementation reflection, and post-implementation reflection. After implementing, after conducting the activity in the classroom, what is your observation and what is your report? What is your reflection? That is what the second one. So you have to design one activity and implement in the classroom, and you have to give a report. That is the assignment number 1. Assignment number 2, again, you have to design 2 activities. So name of the course I have selected is engineering thermodynamics. The topic is basic thermodynamics, and the activity I use is think, pair, share. Activity 1, I use the think, pair, share activity. And again, second activity, again, the topic is engineering, subject is engineering thermodynamics, topic is second law of thermodynamics, and I use the activity think aloud pair problem solving, TAPS. So think, pair, share for theory part, and TAPS for problem solving. So here again, for the 2 activities, I have to write implementation strategy, starting with an activity, presentation, problem solving, learning style addressed, pre-implementation reflection and post-implementation reflection. Everything we have to report, and we have to implement the activity and give a report in the assignment. So this is, there are 2 activities. So dynamics of classroom, it involves active learning technique. You will be given information, you will be the expert will discuss on the various types of active learning techniques, and we have to implement as a learner, we have to implement in the classroom, and we have to give a report about our experience. That is what assignment on the dynamics of classroom. And the module 3 is teaching with technology. So technology, here we are using 2 technology. During the online teaching, we used many technology for our teaching, but in this module, harnessing the power of technology, there are 2 area, virtual lab implementation and flipped classroom. So virtual lab implementation, the online laboratory, the Alun laboratories are available. Virtual labs are available for your subject, whatever you are teaching right now. You have to take one virtual lab and we have to implement, discuss with the students, implement in the classroom and get the result. And you have to get the experience of the student, feedback from the student, and you have to consolidate. And similarly, flipped classroom. So flipped classroom, the simple concept is, it is flipped classroom is very much useful for solving problem. The theory part, so for example, if you are teaching, you are going to solve your problem on a particular concept. The concept will be given to the students, maybe in the form of a document, prepared lecture notes, or in the form of a video. You prepare a video and give it to the students. So one day advance or 1 week advance, you give it to the students and the student will listen to the theory part of the lecture. Then we have to solve the problem on that concept in the classroom. Or if it is a completely theory paper, you can give the theory part document or the video to the students and you can have a discussion or quiz program in the classroom to evaluate the understanding of the students. So this is a flipped classroom technique. So this is the online mode, online using the technology for teaching, that will be discussed and we have to implement in the module 3. Module 4 is collaborative learning. It is again an active learning technique. Collaborative learning is also an active learning technique. And we have two assignments. Assignment 1, you have to plan for a collaborative learning activity. So collaborative learning activity, it is more than the active learning. Active learning may be for 2 minutes or 3 minutes. So when you do an activity inside the classroom for 2 minutes, so it is active learning. Instead, the collaborative learning, it may take 1 period, it may take 2 periods. So first phase, assignment 1, we have to plan for the collaborative activity. So the STAD is the activity I used, student team achievement. So the student will be working in team. The subject is engineering thermodynamics and third semester mechanical engineering. Topic selected is psychrometric properties. Objective of the activity, at the end of the activity, student will be able to infer and explain psychrometric properties. So plan to create team. So what is your plan for creating the team? And the time of the activity is 20 minutes or 30 minutes. You can even plan for 15 minutes, 1 period. The proposal to evaluate the individual and the group performance. How we are going to evaluate the team performance and the individual performance. How you are going to grading the students. Everything we have to propose. That is the assignment 1. Assignment 2 is implementing. So whatever we planned in the assignment 1, that is to be implemented and you have to give a report. Again, the STAD is the activity, engineering thermodynamics, third semester mechanical engineering. Topic selected is psychrometric properties. Introduction on the day of activity. So at the beginning in the classroom, what will you do? How will you instruct the students? What kind of instruction will you give? What is our role as a teacher that we have to write? Reflection on my experience of the collaborative activity. We have to write our reflection. Creating team. What is the procedure and what are the difficulties we faced in the creating the team that we have to report. Steps taken during the collaborative work was going on in the classroom. So when the students are working as a team, what kind of activity that the teacher will do, monitoring the student, motivating the students, and there will be some poor learner, how to help the poor learner, everything we have to do in the, what is the step we take during the act when the activity is going on. And we have to evaluate. Either the teacher can evaluate or we can evaluate with the help of the student. You have to evaluate and prepare the mark statement, and the mark statement we have to report. That is what the implementing collaborative activity. Then module 5 is effective assessment. So here there are two assignments. First assignment, there is one research paper by Richard Felder, recommendation for assessment. So the paper will be given to you. And the paper is available online. There are different points about the assessment techniques, effective assessment. You have to read all the points and you have to give your reflection. So report on Richard Felder key recommendations on designing test to maximize learning. So that is the paper, designing test for to maximize learning. You have to read the paper and you have to give your comment on every point. revision of your, based on the paper, based on the recommendations of Richard Felder or the understanding of the journal paper, you have to revise your question paper. Already you set a question paper for your examination, you take a question paper and revise the question paper based on the Richard Felder recommendation, and you have to submit as a assignment. Revision of question paper based on Richard Felder key recommendations are designing test to maximize learning. That is the assignment one. Assignment two, effective assessment assignment two, it is completely rubrics. So rubric, justify the design process adopted for creating rubrics. Assessment, rubric is an assessment instrument, and the rubric, so how to create rubric, what are the parameters involved in the rubric, that is what discussed, and you have to create a question paper, an assignment with the rubrics. Rubric design is the assignment number two. And the rubrics is very much useful for assessment, particularly the project work, the presentation made by the students. In the Bloom's taxonomy, there are higher end, analyze, evaluate and create. So for assessing the higher end HOT, higher order thinking skills of the students, so the rubrics are very, very important. And module 6 is the course design. So course design, so the how to design a course. Actually, course design affiliated colleges, we are not doing the course design, but in the course design is the syllabus, framing the syllabus or designing the course, particular course. So here there are two assignments. The first assignment, we have to design a course. So I have taken subject code ME6502 Heaton Mass Transfer, 5th semester mechanical engineering. We have to write the syllabus, we have to write the course outcome, and you have to write the program outcome relevant to the subject and the mapping of COPO. That is what the assignment in the first assignment. So already the syllabus is available. So we have to design the course outcome and the PO which is relevant. There are 12 POs in the NBA documentation or our outcome based education. So what are the PO relevant to that particular course that you have to write, and you have to give the justification. And the mapping of COPO, that also we have to give with the proper justification. That is the course design assignment number one. And assignment number two, again, we have to design the subject for the course and how to implement. So the topic I have selected is engineering thermodynamics, third semester mechanical engineering, psychrometric process is the topic. Learning objective for the lecture that I have to write, opening of the lecture. So what is the what I will do in the classroom at the first 10 minutes, and the content for segment one, second 15 minutes I have to make a presentation, and you have to conduct a short activity, then again content for second 15 minutes and closing lecture. So what I will do as a teacher in a particular class, that I have to prepare, implement, and I have to write the reflection report. That is the assignment number two. So on completion of the 12-week program, 6 modules, assignments and the discussion based on the mark, so you will be given the certification. So the IUCE International Engineering Educator Certificate, I have completed the course, successfully completed the course, and I have completed the course with the distinction. So in all the assignment and the discussion, I got about 90% mark. So I completed with the distinction. When you complete the course, including capstone presentation, you have to complete the course. After completing the course, you will be recommended for the IGIP, International Engineering Educator Certification, and the certificate was awarded to me recently, January 10, 2021, in the conference conducted in, virtually conducted conference by IUCE. So, Indo-Universal Collaboration for Engineering Education is conducting international conference virtually. This year they conducted virtually, or every year the conference will be conducted in India. You can physically present, and this year it was virtual. So in the conference, the certificate was awarded to me. Along with me, 19 people, they obtained the certificate across India. So the certification, the process which we are undergoing will be very much useful, particularly to redesign or change our teaching pedagogy, our teaching methodology inside the classroom, which will suit to the latest requirement or to help the student learners. I enjoyed the program, and I learned a lot from the program and the courses, and I learned a lot from the expert whom offered the various modules. And finally, these are all the books helped me throughout the course, creating significant learning experience by debunking how learning works, and taxonomy of education objective by Benjamin Bloom, and teaching learning STEM. So this is very important book by Richard Felder, and teaching engineering, measurement and assessment in teaching, and the exam reform policy, which is published by AICT. So as a teacher, so we have to continuously update our knowledge on the subject, as well as today the pedagogy is very, very important for teaching, effectively teaching the students. So if you find time, please undergo the course, or you register to the website iucee.org, you will get the information. So if you find time, you please undergo the course and learn the newer technology to become an effective teacher. So thank you. If you enjoyed the video, so please share with your friends and recommend the people to learn further to improve your teaching methodology.